Good evening. I'm a little speechless right now, I've got to say. I wasn't expecting this. And I've got to say, you're a pretty fine looking bunch of people too. And I know because I'm wearing my glasses right now so I can see complete detail in the top row. Oh, this is so. My name's Jason Bonham. Welcome to JBLZ. First off, I want to apologize for not coming back to Canada soon. If I'd have known that this is what was going to be the reception, I am just, as I said, I think we're all a little blown away. Thank you so much for coming out to see us. Has anybody seen us play before?
Yeah!
Anybody hasn't seen us play before? That's great. That means some of you are going to hear the same stories. And some of you are going to hear some stories you've never heard before. Hopefully, you'll get to hear a little bit of both. See, what I did was, 13 years ago, I said, I would do this thing, this JBLZE, once. One tour. Yeah. I will do one tour when I pay homage to the greatest rock and roll drummer in the world, John Henry Bonham. Yeah. Pay homage to the music of Robert Plant, Jimmy Page, John Paul Jones, and John Bonham, of course.
Yeah.
The music of Led Zeppelin is timeless. Yeah. To do it, you know, so I thought, you know, we'll do once. One 28-day tour. I can tell a few stories about my dad, about what it was like growing up with a guy that was notorious for throwing TV sets out of windows. Yeah. And for doing some weird things with fish. Apparently. We don't know. There is no film document of it.
We love you!
Thank God. So, I soon realized that it wasn't about me and my stories of my dad. It was about your love for Led Zeppelin.
Yeah!
That's what the show is all about. Because we are fans here. We, in the band, we're fans of the music. This is why we've been doing it for 13 years. Because we love the music as well. And you are the most important thing about tonight, because without you, we are just five guys playing with ourselves.
We love you!
Music, that is. Please, keep it above 18, you know. So, with your help, what we try to do is take you back into time to when some of you maybe had a little bit more hair than you do now. To when you were, the girl that's on your arm was still your girlfriend then. Or somebody else's wife. Fine. It was the 70s. It was fine. When you didn't get your pot from a doctor, you got it the old way. In the back alley, streets, whatever. To when you were going to a concert in that wood panel station wagon. When you were listening to music on 8-track. When the radio would play the whole album as it was meant to be heard from start to finish. Do you get where we're going? We're trying to take you back to that days. So, with that in mind, if we can just make you forget about tomorrow, don't worry about yesterday, just be here right now, today. Let loose, have some fun. Right? So for the next couple of hours, doesn't matter what anyone thinks, let's just do this and let's go over the hills and far away! Thank you.
Hey lady, you've come to love me. Maybe more than enough. Oh darling, 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 what come you out of me? Oh, you got so much, so much, so much. Thank you.
gonna do a little something off of Led Zeppelin too, and I want you guys to sing. I've been telling them about you for weeks now. I said, Canada sings better than everybody else. I have a summer place in Algonquin Park, and I know what Canada's all about. Let's do it. It's a shock.
Yeah.
And if I say to you tomorrow, take my hand, child, come with me. Into the castle I will take you. Where what's to be the same will be. Stop us, pretty baby. But what is it? What should we make of it? We'll be right back.
That's it. You guys remember the very first time you heard Led Zeppelin? The very first time. That album right there? Right on. For me, it was Zeppelin 4. So it was really trippy because I heard it through the bedroom wall between my room and my sister's. And it was muffled, but I understood what was going on. So I went into her bedroom the next day and borrowed it for 40 years. This album was filled with all sorts of great music. I mean, think about it. Black Dog was on this album, right? Then you had Battle of Evermore. You had Rock and Roll. Stairway to Heaven. Misty Mountain Hop, right? That's the backside. Here's another one off the backside. And this particular song, for you drummers out there, this was recorded in a... The drums were recorded in a stairwell. You know what it is. We'll be right back.
I'm still very overwhelmed by looking at all you people. Just keep thinking like, I keep thinking, who else is playing tonight? That's all I keep thinking. What time do they go on? I really appreciate it. So I want to give thanks. Give thanks to the man up above who just delivered me or gave me the most beautiful granddaughter in the world. My first grandchild was born 5 days ago.
Yeah!
A little girl. My little Louis bear. And I thought I was going to be a big tough guy about it and just be like, yeah, whatever, it's just a grandchild, you know. And I just saw her and I was like, wow. For the rest of my life, I'll be taking care of you as well. But I don't mind. I don't mind at all. So, but right now, she's just this tiny, beautiful little thing. And it really does make your heart melt. When I thought, I did not think mine was going to be like that. So I give thanks for giving me that. My daughter and my son-in-law, God bless them both. So I wish them well. So I give thanks. That's what I want to say. I also would like to give thanks to my wonderful, God bless her, grandmother, my dad's mom, Joan Bonham. Joan could out-drink Keith Moon and my father in one go. And she once did. In the 70s, when you thought you were doing well for yourself, you had a bar at home. So, and there would be like ornamental drinks that you never drank. You bought them because it just looked pretty behind the bar in the glass. And one of them was called Creme de Menthe. It was a green liquid, right? And the other was this yellow Warnix Advocar, if anyone remembers that one at Christmas. It's like custard. It was the weirdest thing. But they were alcoholic, right? They were alcohol drinks. But nobody ever drank them. Oh, my grandmother did. When there was nothing else to drink, she did. When my dad and Keith Moon had passed out, then she drank that when there was nothing else to drink. She was feisty. And she, you know, she lived a right good life, you know, late 80s, and still drank on her deathbed. God bless her. But she was the one that took my dad down to the jazz clubs. This is why I'm thanking her. She was the one that forced him on the band leader at 15 years old and said, let my son play drums. So without her influence on pushing him down there to get up and play that kind of music, the influence that my father had by those great jazz drummers, the Joe Morellos, the Buddy Rich, the Gene Krupas, there would never be the John Bonham we know without her forcing him down the jazz club. So I give thanks to my grandmother, Joan Bonham. Give her thanks. The funny side of it was there was another reason she went there. She really thought the trumpet player was hot. And she left grandpa for him and married the trumpet player. Guys, be weary of friends that play trumpet when your wife's around. Don't think of your grandma that way either. But this is my way of saying thank you to trumpet players.
Awesome.
Mountains crumble to the sea.
would still be you and me.
You can tell we're not playing the backing tracks. Oh, of all the times for the things to go wrong is on that one sensitive song. Oh well, guess that's life.
We're gonna do it on the spot right here. This is Rob, by the way.
Rob has had a lot of fun on this tour. He turned 24 the other week, and he's aged 30 years in the last week because of this guitar. Yeah, we want vintage equipment, you see. I was like, I want it to be authentic. So everything we have is so old that it's very unreliable. But when it works, it is magic.
Do we have it?
Oh,
see, when it works, it works. Oh yeah, now we're having fun. Now it feels like it's Saturday. It is Saturday night, right? Let's make it the best Saturday night ever. This is our second to last stop this year. And I gotta say, tomorrow night might be a bit of a letdown after tonight, I gotta say. Just looking around. So let's keep it going. We done four already and now we're steady and then they went.
I'm
So we're gonna change what we had planned here. We're gonna do something special for you guys.
Oh,
5,000 people here tonight. I really don't know.
Now back to our regular program.
Oh,
1979. The album that came in a brown paper bag. David Wild, those boys. They had some crazy ideas when it came to artwork and covers. I mean, do you remember the object that they had in the album Presence, right? It was that weird black object, yeah? So, they all got given one of them to take home in one of these black objects. So, I remember my mum and dad and their friends, after a few drinks, decided to have a seance with that thing and to record what was going to go on. So, of course, you know, with science, we can explain what we heard back on the tape. We were just hearing the reverse from the other side of the tape. Oh no, my mum thought she could hear spirits. And that object was thrown out of the back window as far into the garden as one could throw. And it still lies in that garden today. But it was the 70s, they were a little nuts at the time. But all those weird little objects that we thought, just recently I think they just located the guy who had the twigs on his back on Led Zeppelin 4. You know, that guy's been going through life not knowing that he is so famous. He could have had free drinks all life just for being that guy. Very, very strange. So, 1979. I was 13 years old. I started to buy music for the first time. Still with my dad's money, but this time he didn't know. But he didn't miss it. He could afford it. So I would start up getting into the music thing, and I was into dirt bikes, and I was, you know, 13, so it was dirt bikes, girls, music, whatever order it was. And I suddenly thought this one band that was like, they looked amazing, they sounded amazing, they all had white blonde hair, and they were called The Police. And I was a big Police fan. So I was such a fan that I went straight underneath my mum's sink and found the bleach and bleached all my hair. But my looks of things in the audience tonight, there's a few other Police fans in the audience. So you can imagine it didn't work that good to me. But I was such a fan, I even said to my dad, "You are good, but Stuart Copeland is better than you." Yeah, you didn't say it, I did. And I never got a chance to attract it, but before I could, he'd gone. So, that was the toughest thing with living with all my life. But the greatest thing that he did, he wasn't pissed off. He went, "Play me something." So I played him something from Outlanders the Moor, and I had a blue vinyl copy. I remember it like it was, if I could play you back the video in my head, you would see it. Clear as a bell, playing on his Macintosh system, which I wasn't allowed to touch any other time. Beautiful 1978 solid state power amps, quadraphonic sound, because that was the era. Oh, it just sounded like heaven. Still got it, my mum still got everything working today. Still the same. Still the same. So it was like, I played it and it sounded even better than it did in my room. So he goes, "I like it." He liked it so much, he took me to see The Police the following week. He got me backstage to meet The Police. I was like, "Oh my God." And then he wanted to punch Sting in the face. Dad. So when you're a kid and you think your parents embarrass you, even John Bonham could embarrass me. That was... But I don't know how, because it was just one of those things. It was like, "Dad, please don't embarrass me. Don't punch Sting in the face." So I got to see Sting last year, and I hadn't seen him since 1979. Hadn't seen him, hadn't spoke to him. Walked into the room. He said, "Jason, how long has it been?" And I went, "Well, I haven't seen you since 1979. He goes, "You haven't changed a bit." I want you to punch him in the face at that point. But it was a very cool time for me. So My dad and I would start to listen to music together. He would play me stuff, and I would play him the new stuff that I was into. And those moments, for the short time I had with him, when we were doing that kind of thing, I cherish every moment. And if I didn't tell him enough while he was alive, then this show, and every time I play drums, is my way of telling him that he is the greatest, he always will be the greatest, and I thank him for putting a drum kit at the bottom of my bed on that Christmas day. And ever since then, I thank him. He gave me a trade that I appreciate. It's not like work, it's love of music and him. So, thank you. So enough of that. Let's go back to a 1979 August evening. I saw my dad play drums in front of 200,000 people, and it was a very special moment. A particular arrangement of a song stuck with me all my life, with my help from Mr. Jimmy Sacker right here. We're gonna take you back to that night.
Please come on.
The greatest teacher in the world, that's all. The next song is a gentleman said he would never sing it ever again in his life, and recently he just did. So I always believe this is a song of hope.
Those who stand on, and the forest will echo.
Please give it up for the amazing members of JBLGE. On keyboards and guitar, Mr. Alex Howland. On the bass guitar, we call him Hollywood, Mr. Dorian Hartsong. On the lead guitar, all the way from Tokyo, weighing in at 78 pounds, Mr. Jimmy Sakurai. And on vocals, a man who visits his second home in Canada every summer. The man who has been with me 14 years now. On on guitar, artwork, and vocals, Mr. James Dillon. Now, right before we came on stage, I text my other boss, Mr. Hagar, and I said, tonight I was gonna play in front of the biggest crowd that JBLZE has ever played again. And I told him how many there were. He didn't believe me. So, when I'm gonna say, after three, I want you to say, Sammy who? Okay, ready? So after three. One, two, three.
Sammy who?
I'm going to send in that right now, thank you very much. So, what we normally do now is we go off stage and wait for you to cheer and then we come back on and play. But we're getting old, so if we go off, we sit down, we don't come back. So if you want, let me do a couple more songs, yeah? That looks familiar. I know that guy. I know that guy. I know that flag anywhere. So, I have to test. Country road.
Thank you.
Destination and have a wonderful holiday season. God bless you, honestly. From us, good night.
Bill's going to...